All right, no Tom Holland.
Need glasses.
Ooh.
I do.
Oh, me too. Like, I'm wearing them right now.
No, I don't actually. When I wear glasses, nice. It's a fashion statement.
What was it like making the film as Spider-Man without Robert Downey Jr.?
You know, it was emotional. It was really emotional.
People like you, I think. They're shouting your name.
I think you have fans.
It's so sweet. It was really emotional. You know, I've only ever made a Spider-Man movie with Robert, and he's a great friend of mine. And, you know, I was FaceTiming him last night, and he wished me the best of luck. And you know, we'll miss him, but he'll never be forgotten.
I heard a rumor, and I don't know if it's true, so I need you to tell me. Does he have a special name in your phone?
He's the Godfather in my phone. Yeah. He's like RDJ the Godfather. Yeah, that's what I have him as.
All right. Okay, confirmed. That is true. Okay.
It is, yeah.
How much of MJ is like yourself?
You know, surprisingly, quite a lot. Maybe our personalities are a little different because I know how to, like, interact with people a little better. But, yeah, I still think we connect on the awkwardness. I think I'm still also trying to figure out how to talk to people that I like. So I can relate to her on that. But also I just think our want to just kind of, I don't know, be alone, yeah. I guess, to be honest. Is that sad to say? But
about the romance on
yes.
set.
Okay.
We've heard about so much about this romance on set. This bromance, if you will. You.
It's really a romance.
Tom. Yeah. Oh, yeah? Straight up?
I'm just tired of the word bromance. Let's just call it like it is. It's a straight up romance.
Between me and Jake?
Between you and Jake.
Oh, it's full on in love. We're getting married. Where is he? Where's my husband?
I'm going wild.
It's crazy.
You guys worked out together? Did you go easy on him?
Once we did. We worked out once.
Once?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And how was that experience?
I'm right at the edge where I can still kind of take him. He definitely can't run on a treadmill.
He said that you're not great on the treadmill.
No.
Kind of run circles around you, huh?
I can't believe he's saying this behind my back. Where is that guy? There he is.
What, are you going to backflip around him?
Or? I'm going to kick him. That's what I'm going to do.
What do you think of the fame that your brother, who has come along, he's been filming you and making these movies. What do you think of him, his Hollywood star rising just by being along for the ride?
Well, you know, him and I, we want to direct movies together. We're writing a film. We're going to hopefully direct it this year. And him being a little bit famous might help. So, yeah.
We're there for
Yeah, absolutely.
They're really short bangs, too, in the comics.
Yes.
He has, like, really short bangs.
They are fairly silly, and I love it. But you also got to get silly with Tom Holland. I love your dynamic on screen. What was it like working together?
I mean, he's great. He's about to show up right now. You're going to hear how everybody else... I feel about him the same way they're about to feel. Yeah, here we go.
When you going to scream?
I did. I feel like screaming when I see him.
Just go ahead. Just go
Every
ahead.
Time
it's
I
okay.
see him. No, I mean, he's a consummate professional. I think we share some similarities in that we both started acting very young. And I love his commitment to his craft outside of him being the best Spider-Man around to put on that costume. He's a physical actor. He is humble. He is deferential to those who are a little bit older than him in a way that you would never expect from somebody who is in his position, who has the power that he has. And I just adore him. I think he's great.
You have some big swashbuckling scenes ahead of you. Well, ahead of us, because we haven't seen it, but you've already shot them. What was it like getting in on some of the action?
Oh, so much fun. I mean, such an incredible group of people who made this movie, and the stunt guys, the visual effects and everything. I mean, it's so much bigger than the last one, and I was a big fan of the last one, so then they asked me to do this one and told me what Mysterio was up to. I was so in.
Well, I'm in too.
All right.
You are an actor that is known for going through physical transformations for roles. What did you go through in order to prepare for this one?
Well, I mean, in truth, the biggest thing for me was the suit. You know, like as soon as I put on the suit, I was pretty much transformed. I mean, I loved it. So I was a little worried about the fishbowl helmet.
Jake was once rumored to maybe be Spider-Man. What do you think his take on it would have been? Did you ever ask him anything about that?
We've spoken about it a little bit, and I have some insight into it that I'm not going to talk about because it's not my story. But no, it's pretty cool. It's a pretty full circle story that, you know, he's here today in a Spider-Man movie playing such an awesome character that is Mysterio.
Kind of coming off the events of Endgame, what is it like for you carrying on this character, and where do you see hopefully Peter going from here?
Wow, where do I see him hopefully going from here? What I've learned about that question is the best way to answer it is to not answer it, because my ideas are never as good as Kevin's and John's and Tom Rothman's and Amy Pascal. So I just love this character so much, and the fact that we get to, you know, explore the relationship between Happy Hogan and Peter Moore is so great.
If you're nothing about this suit, then you shouldn't have it.
Palomitas Cinépolis, hechas de cine.
Fish and chips. Have a pint for myself. Yeah. Oh. They are so good.
Thank you for watching Kyle Review.